Hi. Sequences as discrete functions. Let's talk about sequences. Sequences are also called progressions. A sequence is a list of numbers arranged in a particular order. For example, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Another example, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and so on. This one is a finite sequence. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It has 5 terms. And this one is an infinite sequence. It got no last term. A sequence is an ordered list of numbers. As in members of a sequence, there is a definite order, so a correspondence can be established by matching them one by one with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. These are set of natural numbers. For example, we have a sequence of first 5 odd numbers, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. So we can have the correspondence of the form 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. 1 is first number in the sequence. 3 is second number. 5 is the third number. 7 is fourth number. And 9 is fifth number. So we can say a sequence is a function from a subset of natural numbers to real numbers. Let's say A is the subset 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of natural numbers to real numbers. This is the sequence. A sequence is a function from a subset of natural numbers n to set of real numbers r. We usually label a sequence with D and use N instead of X as variable. For a natural number N from domain of a sequence, say T of N, the corresponding element in its range is denoted by T sub N. The elements in the range of sequence T1, T2, T3, and so on are called its terms. T1 is the first term, T2 is the second term, T3 is the third term, and so on. Tn is the nth term, or we call it general term. We are given general terms of two sequences, 2n minus 3, and the second one is T sub n is equal to n over 2n plus 1. We are asked to find the first 3 terms of these sequences. We just have to plug in 1, 2, 3. For n is equal to 1, 2 times 1 minus 3. 2 minus 3, this is minus 1. For second term, 2 into 2 minus 3. 2 2s are 4, 4 and 3, difference is 1. And the third term, 2 into 3 minus 3. 3 2s are 6, 6 and 3, difference is 3. So these are the first three terms. In this sequence, if I substitute n is equal to 1, 1 by 2 into 1 plus 1. 2 times 1 is 2 plus 1, 3. So the first term is 1 by 3. Second term, 1 by 2 into 2 plus 1. 2 2s are 4 plus 1, 5. So 1 by 5. Third term is, okay. We just missed this n. We have to substitute n is equal to 2. So this is 2 by 5. And for T3, first of all, n is equal to 3. And then 2 into, replace this n with 3 as well, plus 1. 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. So 3 by 7. These are the first three terms. 1 by 3, 2 by 5, and 3 by 7. Similarly, by substituting n is equal to 4, 5, and so on, we can find the other terms. Okay, find the indicated terms of the following sequences. First sequence is 5, 8, 11, 14, and so on. We are asked to find T6. Second sequence here is 1, 3, 12, 60, and so on. We have to find 6 terms for this sequence as well. 1, 1, minus 3, 5, minus 7, 9, and so on. T10, we have to find 10th term here. These terms, first term is 1, second term is 1. In a set, repetition is not allowed, but in a sequence, repetition is allowed. Okay?
Okay, let's quickly go through the first one. 5 and 8, difference is 3. 8 and 11, difference is 3. 11 and 14, once again the difference is 3. It implies that each time we add 3 and get next term. These are 4 terms and we need to find T6. For T5, 14 plus 3, it is 17. And for T6, 17 plus 3, 20. This is the solution for part 1. For second part, let's make a table using given values and check its finite differences for a pattern.
3 and 1, difference is 2. 12 and 3, difference is 9. 60 and 12, difference is 48. And if I take second differences, 2 and 9, it's 7. 9 and 48, it's 39. So finite differences are not going to work here. Okay, let's try factors. 1 and 3, factor is 3. 3 and 12, factor is 4. 3 4s are 12. 12 and 60, 12 5 times 60. So yes, it worked. That means if I am going to find fifth term, it will be 60 times next factor 3, 4, 5, 6. And 60 times 6 is 360. So the sixth term, 360 times 7, 0, 7, 6 are 42, 4, 7, 3 are 21, 2520. So this is the sixth term. Okay, the third one, 1, 1, minus 3, 5, minus 7, 9, and so on, T10. We make a table of values using the term number n and the term Tn and calculate its finite differences. And let's see if we are able to get a patron. Okay, if these numbers were positive, 3, 5, 7, 9, then this is a sequence of odd numbers. But I wonder what this 1 is doing here. Okay, I got an idea. I'm writing down 1, minus 3 and minus 7 separate. And this 1, 5 and 9 separate. Let me label it N, T, N differences. 1, 5 and 9. This is first term, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and we have to find T10, 10th term. Okay, 1 and minus 3, the difference is minus 4. Minus 3 and minus 7, the difference is once again minus 4. So we can find the next term. Sixth term is here, so we can find the seventh term, minus 7 and again minus 4, so minus 11. Let's see what we have from here. 1 and 5, the difference is 4. 9 and 5, the difference is once again 4. So we can get 8th term from here. 9 and add 4, 9 and 4, 13. Okay, T10, just 2 steps to go home. T9, minus 11 and minus 4, minus 15. T10th, 13 and 4, 17. So yes, the 10th term is 17. Let's explore the pattern of a floor tile that is designed using nested squares. A, B, C, D. This is the first square. E, F, G, H. These are midpoints. These are joined by straight line segments. And this is another square. I, J, K, L midpoints joined consecutively. And another square. Another square. This square. And so on. This is the pattern. Let's find out what sequence is behind this. We make a table using the values number of squares, let's call it n, and number of regions, let's say tn. Okay, here we go. This is first square and has only one region in it. So I can write 1 corresponds to 1. Okay, midpoints. And so how many squares? These are 2 squares. And regions, let me count 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Total 5 regions. 2 squares corresponds to 5 regions. Midpoints. Let's join them. So we obtain 4 more regions, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So this time, 3 squares and 9 regions. 3, 9. Okay. One more little square here. 4 more regions, 10, 11, 12, and 13, and so on, okay? So, when I have 4 squares, it divides the whole tile into 13 regions. Continuing in the same way, when I have 5 squares in it, it will divide in 17 regions. For 6, 21. For 7, 25, and so on. Using this information, let's determine an explicit formula to describe the number of regions according to the number of squares. 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. 1, 5, 9, 13. 1, 5, 9, and 13, so on. Difference of 5 and 1. This is 4. 9 and 5, 4. And every time the difference is 4. We can draw a graph. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, and 13. One, one, first order pair. Two and five. Two from here. Five from here. Here we go. Three corresponds to nine. Here. And 4 corresponds to 13. Do not join these dots, okay? Because this is a discrete function. For example, if you join these dots, 1, 1, 2, 5 and 3, 9. For example, if you join these dots, it would imply that for 1.5, the corresponding value is 3. It means for 1.5 squares, 1.5 square doesn't make any sense, okay? So we cannot join these points. This sequence is not a continuous function, it is a discrete function. As the first finite differences are constant, so this function is linear. The first finite difference corresponds to the value of A in linear function t of n, that is, this linear function is equal to value for A is 4, so 4n plus b. All we have to do is to evaluate B, and to find B we can use one of these ordered pairs 1 1 2 5 3 9 4 13, any of them. Let's choose the first ordered pair 1 1, that is T of n is equal to 4 n plus B. If I choose 1 1, that means n is 1 and T of n is also 1. So 1 is equal to 4 times 1 plus b, 4 plus b. So yes, it will give value for b, 1 and 4 difference minus 3. So the value for b is minus 3. And so T of n is 4n, value for b is minus 3. And this is the explicit formula to determine the terms in the sequence. Okay, we have one more sequence, 1, 10, 25, 46, and so on. We have to find out its general term, okay? Let's make a table of values using the term number and the term Tn. 1, 2, 3, 4, First term is 1, second is 10, third is 25, fourth is 46. Okay, first finite differences. One and ten. The difference is 9. 25 and 10, difference is 15. 46 and 25, the difference is 21. The differences are not constant. So let's find the second differences. Let me write down first here. Okay. Second differences. So 9 and 15, second difference is 6. 21 and 15, second difference is 6. So yes, the second differences are constant. So the explicit formula is going to be a quadratic function. And half the value of second difference, that is 3, corresponds, let me write down, half the value of second difference corresponds to the value of A in quadratic function, and the quadratic function is of the form let's say T of n equals a n square plus b n and plus c. A, b, c are any real numbers, but we have value of a so far 6. Half of 6 is 3, right? So that is T of n is 3 n square plus b times n plus c. To determine the values for b and c, let's substitute the coordinates of two points, any two points. Let's choose 1, 1 and 2, 10. 1, 1 and the second one I have chosen is 2, 10. The quadratic function so far I have 3n square plus bn plus c. 1, 1. This first number is value for n and the second is value for tn. So 1 is equal to 3 times 1 square plus b times 1 plus c. This is 3 plus b plus c. So b plus c is equal to 1 and 3. Difference is minus 2. Let's call it 1. Second equation, 2, 10. 10 is the value for tn, the range. And 2 is the input, n. So 3 into 2 square plus b times 2. Plus c. 2 square is 4, 4 into 3, 12, plus 2b plus c. So 2b plus c, 10 and 12. Difference is minus 2, equation 2. So we can solve these two linear equations. 2b plus c is equal to minus 2, and down here b plus c is equal to minus 2. If I subtract, cancel out, so we left with 2b and b, difference is b. So yes, the value for b is 0. Okay, so far the explicit function is 3n square plus c. All we have to find the value for c. We can substitute value for b in either of these equations. Let's say choose 1. B plus c is minus 2. When b is 0, so c is minus 2. That's it. So the function t of n is 3n square, b vanishes, we left with c, c is minus 2, so 3n square minus 2. This is the explicit formula to determine the terms in the sequence. We have one last sequence, minus 1, 2, 12 and 40. We have to find out its nth term or general term, or we can call it explicit formula to represent the terms of the sequence. Okay, so far I have term number and term, 1, 2, 3, 4 terms, minus 1, to 1240. Okay, just pause the video here and try to find yourself the explicit formula for this sequence. Okay, welcome back. Now I show you how I did this. I'm just writing odd numbers starting from minus 1. You know the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on. So if I go on the negative side, minus 1, minus 3, minus 5 and so on. These are the odd numbers, right? So I started from minus 1. Minus 1, then 1, 3 and 5. Okay. This is minus 1 times 1. It's fine. This is 1 times 2. And this is 3 times 4. 3 fours are 12. And this is 5 times 8. Okay. Let's move on. Minus 1, 1, 3 and 5. These are just powers of 2. This is 2 raised to power 3. This is 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 1, and you know 2 raised to power 0. Any non-zero number raised to power 0 except 1 is 1, okay? So this is the pattern. These are the odd numbers, and here these terms are powers of 2, but starting from 0. Means you have input 1 and the power is 0. 2, the power is 1, means for n, you have the output n minus 1. 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. When we substitute 2, 2 minus 1 is 1, and so on. We just have to figure out what explicit formula represent these odd numbers, okay? So, minus 1, 1, 3 and 5. The difference is 2, everybody knows. So, and it's linear because first difference is constant. So, let me just write down A of n for only these numbers is equal to 2n plus b. In order to find b, let's substitute very first point. For first, our first odd number is minus 1. So this is minus 1 and the position n is 1. So 2 times 1 is 2. And this will result minus 1 and minus 2, minus 3. So yes, this is 2n minus 3. So finally, the explicit formula for Tn is going to be odd number 2n minus 3 times 2 raised to power n minus 1. I hope you got the idea, and thank you very much.